As you leave, you're leaving this unbelievably beautiful, naked, charcoal ball out there in space. And you've been around the moon. You've been on it. You're seeing something familiar to you. That's home. That's where we live. There's where we left the lunar rover, and there's where we explored, and there's the mountains and the valleys. And it is, in a sense, has been a home, a life-sustaining home for you. And when you leave it and you see those things, you leave it with the same kind of feeling and awe that you left the Earth with several days earlier.
When we were about 30 minutes from rendezvous with the command module, I was over on the right-hand side working with my backup computer and my charts and watching the systems. Pete Conrad was running the primary computer and doing the controlling of the lunar module out at the left-hand window. Pete said to me, "Boy, Al, you look like you're working too hard over there. You want to take a break?" Well, I've been training with this guy for 2 years and he never told me to take a break on any rendezvous. And here we were doing for real. And he looked over at me and said, "You want to fly this thing?" And I said, "Well, yeah, I'd like to fly it." As I took the controls out, "Well, wait a minute. The people on Earth in Mission Control aren't going to like this." And to show how he thinks about things, he said, "Don't worry about it. We're on the backside of the moon. They'll never know."
A nice looking machine.
It was all over, and we put it all back to zero, and before we came out on the side of the moon where you can see the Earth, we were back steadily rendezvousing.
Eagle Houston, you're looking good there.
Roger, Houston, we are returning to the Earth. Over.
Glad to have you on the way back home.
I think I must have the feeling that the travelers in the old sailing ship used to have. You're going on a very long voyage away from home, and now we're headed back. I have that feeling of being proud of the trip, but still happy to be going back home and back to our home port.
As time goes on, I truly do believe that you're able to pull out of the subconscious a great many things that you absorbed in those moments while you were there looking back at the Earth or realizing you were on another planet. And I can almost transform my body, certainly my mind, through time and space instantaneously to that spot on the moon. I know where I am when I look at the moon. It's not just some abstract romantic idea. It's something very real to me. Stars are my home.
We set sail on this new sea because there is new knowledge to be gained and new rights to be won, and they must be won and used for the progress of all mankind.